to understand, one side, we are always taught desires are wrong, desires are wrong, desires are wrong. But the other side, desire is energy. What is happening? What is the problem? Desire as such has no problem. When we create self-contradicting desires, that is where the problem starts. Our desires are so unconscious, we do not know the consequences. First thing, we create self-contradicting engrams, self-contradicting desires. Next thing, two separate desires which are contradicting. In one desire itself, it will be self-contradicting. And two separate desires, which will be contradicting. One side, you don't want to take any responsibility. Mind wants just to be free from all responsibility. Other side, it wants all the comforts. This is two desires contradicting each other. You always visualize lying in our beach and without any responsibility, having vacation. Always you desire for that. The other side, you want all the money to fly away to Hawaii and to book a resort for everything. Both desires are self-contradicting, because if you have to fulfill one desire, the money, to go to Hawaii and book a resort and relax, you need money. For that money, naturally you need to work. The other side, you want to always relax. What to do wrong with these two desires? Then you will be working, thinking of lying and resting in Hawaii beach. And when you are lying and resting in the Hawaii beach, you will be thinking of all your work. That's all. When you create something which is contradicting each other, you create a confusion. And you will be doing that when you are doing this. You are doing this when you are doing that. This is one type. The other type, in a same engram, same samskara, creating self-contradicting. Just today morning you are saying, for example, if you have a headache, saying, I should get rid of this headache. Then every time you are giving power to the word headache, you are giving power to the concept headache, naturally it will never leave you. Whatever is again and again repeated in your inner space becomes powerful. It gets power. It just settles down. It is deeply inscribed in your inner space. And naturally, when it is inscribed in your inner space, it becomes powerful. In the single statement itself, you create a self-contradicting or two separate self-contradicting. Now, third thing which you need to understand, how you handle your desire energy. When the desire energy, if it is handled, only in three levels you handle the desire energy. One level, too many desires. Too many desires will always be self-contradicting. Even two desires will be contradicting, self-contradicting. For example, you have one desire to leave this room, this hall, through that way. You have another one desire to leave through this way. Now these two will be contradicting and you will be running between these two gates, that's all. Any two desires will be self-contradicting. This is the one level, how you will use the desire energy. Second, there is only one desire, only one object without second. When you are having only one object, you will fulfill the desire, then suddenly you will feel the emptiness. It is not worth fulfilling. The third level, there will be no object, just overflowing, bubbling desire energy. Desire without object is what I call life, living energy. Desire without object is what I call bliss. A pure desire energy, bubbling energy, but without directed towards any object. You can see that energy in the kids. They will be just flowing, overflowing, bubbling, but not towards any particular object. three level. First, two different desires contradicting each other. Second, same desire self contradicting. The third, three levels of using desire energy. One, with too many desires. Second, with one desire, but after achieving feeling emptiness. Third, desire without object. Now, if you start purifying your desire energy, you will come and stand in this state, desire without objects. Pure overflowing energy, enthusiasm, inspiration, but not directed towards one object. Just overflowing for no reason. That's what I call bliss. When you purify your desire energy, you come and stand in this state. This state is what I call Satori or Samadhi, glimpse of Samadhi. Thoughtless awareness happens to you when you are aware, but not particularly aware of some object. As long as you are aware of some object, you will have desire about it. Here, you are aware, but not towards any object. You are just in pure awareness state. By refining your desires, you can reach the pure awareness state. Not by suppressing, but by refining. In the pure awareness state, you will not have desire. But if you start directly fighting the desire, you will not achieve the pure awareness state. That's a mistake all the religions have done. Because in pure awareness there is no desire, they started thinking if we stop all the desires, we will achieve the pure awareness state. No. It is not vice versa. You can't achieve the state by creating the status. Now, we will do three different level things to work on our own inner space, especially this pranic layer. First, whatever desires you have, bring them all to conscious level. Now there are so many sitting inside and you fight with them. Because you fight with your desires, they are not expressed to you properly. You always suppress them. Because you suppress them, even you don't know what desires you carry. Your own desires become unconscious to yourself. Now, first time, open it to your own self and bring everything to conscious layer. Be very clear what you are thinking. What's happened? Completely be aware of what your desires are. Whatever you are thinking, just spend down. You are not going to show to anybody. You are going to have only for yourself. Just spend down the whole thing. Then we will start editing how we are creating self-contradicting engrams, self-contradicting desires. We will understand. And the third, we will infuse energy into the desires. One more thing. Mahavir says beautifully, when you come down to the planet Earth, you bring enough of energy to work out all your desires, then why are we feeling that we don't have enough money, enough time, enough energy to enjoy our desires? Why do we feel we don't have enough? Please be very clear. It's like from here you go to downtown taking $10,000 to buy a car. After going there, you see one of your friends. He calls, "No, no, come, let us go to the electronic shop, Price Electronics." You go there and get TV, fridge, and buy all these electronic stuff and blow up all the money. Then after that, if you want to have a car, you can't have. Naturally, you'll start using the credit card. Same way, when you come down, you bring a set of desires.
and enough energy to fulfill those desires. That is what we call prarapta karma. What you bring to fulfill in this life. But after taking the body, after assuming the body, you start collecting desires from society. Society infuses desires in you. The desires forced on you by society, you start fulfilling them also, fulfilling those desires also. If your father wants to become a doctor and he is not able to, he expects you to become. Now you are spending your whole life just to fulfill his desire. When you start fulfilling somebody else's desire, be very clear, you are caught in the trap. Naturally you will feel you don't have enough energy, you don't have enough time, you don't have enough money to fulfill your life. You will start feeling this is short, that is short, this is not sufficient, that's not enough. Why? Because you are not fulfilling only your desires. You start fulfilling somebody else's desires also. Do not waste your life in fulfilling somebody else's desire. The next question will come. How to know which is my desire and which is imposed on me? Which is forced on me? When you infuse consciousness, when you meditate on pranic layer, whatever is imposed on you, all those desires will automatically drop. It's like shaking a tree. If you shake a tree wildly, whatever dry leaves are hanging, all those things will drop. Leaf belongs to the tree, that will stay, but all the dry leaves will fall. Same way, now we are going to shake the pranic layer by a particular meditation. When you infuse energy into pranic layer, when you flood awareness into the pranic layer, when you bring your consciousness to the pranic level, prana energy to the pranic energy, whatever desires which is not yours, imposed on you, will automatically drop and die down. Just last MSP, in Vancouver, one devotee, he was telling me, he did already one MSP, second time he came. He says, Swamiji, I thought that when you said the desires will drop, maybe I have to believe. But after the meditation, now I understand, really I forgot so many things which was haunting me. I forgot. I never thought I'll have such big relief. Please understand, the meditation on this pranic layer is so powerful. Actually, your dreams, your desires and this world, all three are made of same stuff. Your dreams, your desires, this world, all three are made of same stuff. Very difficult to understand, but truth. All three are made of same stuff. When you work on the pranic layer, you clear all the three. When you clear some one thing, all the other two are automatically clean. Now, when you meditate, work on the pranic layer, automatically you will see, even if you force your mind, doesn't go behind desires. The pranic layer, when we do meditation, we will be doing that only. You will be just going behind all the desires, one by one. Just leaving them completely. Suddenly you will see your mind comes back again and again to only one or two desires. All other things are dropping. They are not there anymore. Just they are disappearing. That's what I say. When you shake the tree, all old leaves drop by themselves. You don't have to do anything. When you infuse energy into pranic layer, when you bring spirit into pranic layer, automatically all the desires imposed on you, infused in you, they just drop. Whatever desires you brought, the prarapta karma. When you design your body, you design according to your desires.
and those memories are staying in your body. And after coming, after taking the body, by and by so many desires are infused on you, your pranic flow completely changes. You start breathing very shallow way. Man who breathes deeply will never be taken away by any desires, I tell you. You can see very clearly, your breathing has become shallow. Because continuously social conditioning. If you see kids breathing, they are breathing using the whole body. Their whole body will breathe. The moment social conditioning starts happening, your breathing will become shallow. Your body and pranic flow is designed for your prarabdha karma, means the samskaras which you brought. The moment society starts adding samskaras, the pranic flow is disturbed. Pranic flow is destroyed. Now, I am bringing the pranic, original pranic flow back to your being. The moment original pranic flow is brought back, automatically, the infused samskaras drop. The forced desires automatically die down. It may look like how such big thing can be achieved by such a small exercise. You may think, please be very clear, you always fought with desires from the wrong karma. Like a Vali. Vali is a character in Ramayana. Vali has got a special boon. Anybody who stands in front of him to fight with him, half of his power will go away to him. Half of his power will go away to Vali. Same way, the moment you start fighting in front of your desires, half of your power is already taken by desires. Naturally, you are failure. And you start, by and by, you start believing desires are more powerful than you. When that belief is strengthened, simply you are defeated. Before desire starts, simply you are defeated. Because you have strong belief, desires are more powerful than you. Now it is time to open the whole Pandora box. To open the whole Pandora box.